Hi, Chris Wallace from TGW. We're in Phoenix, Arizona today at Ping headquarters. I'm with Marty Jertson. We're talking about new G400 products, and specifically right now we're going to talk about the new G400 irons. G's obviously been an incredibly successful franchise for you guys in irons, and this is another quality addition. Tell us sort of what's new about this in fueling performance.
Yeah, so our G iron, we like to think of it as a game enjoyment iron. This iron is a lot of fun to hit. You hit some earlier today. I think you were having a good time out there yourself.
Yeah, so, I was.
You know, there's a lot to this iron, and what we're out to produce here with this product is an iron that goes high, goes far, and gives you a lot of stopping power, but also feels really good for a distance-minded iron. That's a really unique combination. You know, it's kind of easy to make a distance iron, but you sacrifice, you know, maybe gapping, feel, you can't stop the ball in the green, distance control, those type of things. This gives you the holy grail of all that stuff combined. You know, there's a lot of technology that goes into how it works.
Yeah, and I know one of the big things is that you guys have really thinned out this club face that's creating a lot of distance.
Yeah, so with the G Max and the G, we launched this COR-Eye technology, which is this localized stiffening member, this circle right in the middle of the face that locally stiffens the face, but it forces the face to flex at the bottom and the top rail to relax. So we've supplemented that COR-Eye technology with a full top rail undercut. So we've saved a lot of weight from the top of the face, and we've achieved even more this catapulting launch effect that takes place during the impact, which is why the iron gives that unique combination of distance and height at the same time.
Yeah, and that's the thing we saw in testing was that yardages were up, launch angles were up, but the spin rates weren't dropping down to where the ball's not going to stop on the green. So how were you able to accomplish that where with a 7-iron, you know, it could still keep that spin rate around 6,000, where a lot of game improvement irons you're dropping down.
Yeah,
much lower.
Too low, or you know, one might think if the face is going like this, it's going to add spin or too much spin, right? So we want to hit that sweet spot. So it all comes down to the flexing mechanics, and the way the face moves in that diving board behavior allows us to achieve that unique combination of high launch and the appropriate amount of optimized spin that still you can achieve that landing angle to stop it on the greens.
From a personal standpoint, testing these this morning, the launch angle I got, the feel I got, the spin numbers I got, all were reminiscent of more of a player's iron, even though this would maybe categorize as game improvement, game enjoyment, as you said. But in looking at the lofts, it's amazing that you're able to do that with the stronger lofts. How is that accomplished?
Yeah, so we were on a mission with this iron to produce distance, but do it in a very unique way that gives this iron a direct competitive advantage in that it does several things that other distance irons on the market simply don't do. Number one, it goes really high, so you can hit towering iron shots. It will allow the players like you and I to hit irons more like a tour player. So it goes high. It doesn't have hot spots, so even though it's hot, you don't have those impacts on the face that go flying 10 or 15 yards over the green. The precision is really good with this iron, and for a distance iron, it feels amazing. So it does three unique things that other distance irons on the market really don't do. And it all comes down to this COR-Eye technology, the flexing mechanics. Even though the lofts are a half a degree stronger, we're getting more dynamic flexing of the face to launch the ball up in the air. So even though the loft's a little bit stronger than the G, the peak trajectory is about 5% higher than the G, which is pretty interesting, and it all comes down to the flexing mechanics of the face.
The other thing I think you deserve a lot of credit for from a design standpoint is if you look at the iron, you can see the thicker sole, the mass in the back that's going to give you some confidence. But at a dress, that's all beautifully hidden.
Yeah, so what's fun about this, we've saved weight from the face. The iron is higher inertia by about 4 or 5% compared to the G, so it has tons of stability. But you look at it in the playing position, and a lot of players look down and think this is an I-series iron.
Yeah.
Because we've added this beautiful Hydropearl plating finish. We've brought in some of the lines and inspiration to the top rail and the shaping of the iron. Borrowed a little bit of the language from our I-200 style of product. The iron still has size to it, but it looks very clean and very inspirational in the playing position.
And so a lot of what you said more eloquently than I ever could, is that this is going to fit a lot of people.
Yeah, this iron's going to have a very broad appeal to it, and I think one thing to mention is also the feel for a distance-minded iron.
Yeah.
This multi-material composite badge uses an elastomer material called Santoprene, which is great at absorbing the impact vibrations and kind of creating that really unique. You get the feel of the ball speed coming off the face, but with this nice muted overall signature to the sound. Really unique combination for a distance-minded iron.
Marty, good looking iron. We appreciate it.
All right, thanks.